Hey guys, so in this video we are going to see how to make a simple cloth physics in Lens Studio. In the recent Lens Studio version 4, they have released something called cloth physics that lets you create a realistic cloth kind of physics on any 3D model you want. So there is certain things you need to do to achieve it. So this is a simple lens that I created where based on the model's movements, the flag is dynamically moved. So this is actually happening on real time on the user's mobile. So what we are going to do today is that we are going to see how to make a simple cloth physics. So how this works is that you can have any model you want, and then you would actually like paint any color you want on a vertex, like on the vertex itself. So based on that color, you'll be applying different kind of physics to the cloth or the object. So what we are going to do now is I'm just going to create a simple cloth kind of like any mesh. I'll just delete all the elements. I'll just create a simple plane. I'll rotate it. I'll subdivide it multiple times so it has some kind of a vertex. I'll just also move this little down. So it's move this down so it is kind of like larger, not small kind of thing. So now you can just see this is a very basic model. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to the vertex paint and I'll just pick a RGB color. Make sure you paint it the RGB and not SS. So I'm just going to paint it on the top. So now why we are going to paint it is that on the cloth physics, what's going to happen is that the red color will be so stiff that it's kind of like it will not even move. Like even if whatever you do, that is going to be like a static thing which is attached to something called like some other elements like a pole or something like that. Whereas the bottom element is where the cloth physics will happen, like going up and down. So this is the basic model we are going to use. So now I'm just going to export this. So now you can open the Lens Studio. You can open Lens Studio and open the template, simulation template. Now you will have two examples. The one is like the scarf based example. The other one is the vertex color based example. As I told before, in this case, if you see this model has a red color, yellow color and a green color, and each thing affects the movement separately. So this movement is basically like happening like on real time. So what's happening is it's not baked animation, it's basically happening in the real time. So based on the vertex paint, the settings is applied. So as you can see over here, if I just select it, you can just see these settings can be modified for like any color. Like you can just pick this color and then you can just change it to orange or like any color you want. So in our case, we made it pure red. So I'll just import that into the scene. So while importing, make sure the import vertex color is also checked in, because this cloth simulation basically works totally on the vertex color. So what I'm going to do is I'll just delete all the examples because it's kind of confusing in the beginning. So I'm just going to create a simple script where I'm just going to open the script and paste the cloth simulation in it. So now what is this is that these are the settings that is going to affect the cloth, how it works. So first we need a mesh. So we can't use this prefab directly. We need to use this plane, like the mesh we created. In our case, I'm just dragging the mesh into directly, and we can apply any material. As of now, I'll just apply the debug material because it's easy to see what's happening in the elements. So now what we need is that we need something for the plane to follow. That is, it can be of anything. It can be like head tracking or like something like that, or it can be a model, it can be a 3D model, it can be anything. So in this case, I'm just going to create a simple head binding and I'll put some random empty objects under it. So now if I just select this and apply this to here, you might not see it openly, but something is happening. As this is small, you might not see it clearly. So what I will do is I'll just make this louder, bigger. Okay. now you can just see it's coming because we had the occulter, it was hiding behind it. So now if I just refresh it, okay, I'll just, it's actually the normals of flip, so I'm just going to make it double sided. Yeah, now you can just see it clearly. So if I just click this under this, if I just move it, you can just see the cloth physics is happening. Like if I just pull it up, the model is kind of rotated. I'll just rotate it 90 degrees. Now you can see it clearly that if I just move, you can just see the top part or the red part where we painted is not moving, but the bottom part is moving. It's kind of like how we want it. So if I just go to this color, we can even customize it. Like if I, as I told before, I was controlling with this object, screen object. So basically we need a object to follow, like a follow object to make this work properly. So you can even put it under the face binding directly, or like you can just use any 3D model in this case, or like even you can use the full body tracking model on it. So you can change how stiff it is, or like how resistible it is. Like these settings are mostly for like if you want to play around with it or like experiment it more. So in case you want like already pre-built materials, elements like that, they have something called the fabric controller, which is like if you just deactivate it, you can just see few of these elements will be shifted. That's the basic idea. So if I just click on the fabric controller, I can just add a fabric controller in this. It's a new script where I can just drag it and drop it here. I'll just close this script. So this fabric controller, what this does is, as you can see, this template comes with multiple fabrics like silk, plastic, or like the lace material, or these multiple materials. And these multiple materials consist of different stiffness or bendness, and everything is different for that. So what we'll be needing is that we need to create, these are already built, so it is easy for us to follow that. So now I'm just linking to the script, so this file is getting it. Now you can just see this is a silk material. So if I just move this scene object, you can just see it reacts like a silk one. Whereas if I just change the settings like to some other things, it doesn't matter what material you put, but these properties matter. So like if I just put lace, the settings is different. So I'm just putting like lace material to it. Now you can just see, yeah, this is the issue over here is because of the UV thing. I just made this model a simple model, but if I just click it and then drag it up and down, you can just see it's actually responding like how a normal cloth will respond. So you can use this technique to basically simulate any kind of cloth. To make this more fun, this is actually happening real time. So now it is attached to the face. So it is reacting with the characters, it's attached to the face. So even if the character moves left or right, it is like attached to it and it reacts with the character. So you can use a body tracking and like put elements on it or add to it. So in case you want to add multiple models or elements, what you can do is you can just use the follow element. Like for example, you can add one mesh over here. I'll just, for demo purpose, I'll just add a random mesh over here. So now what will it look like is that this scene, like the cloth will be attached to this model. So wherever this model goes, wherever it is animated, it will be animating with this thing. So we need to make sure you are controlling the follow object, scene object, not the one which has the cloth simulation script, because the control point is basically whatever you are giving it over here. You can attach it to any part of the body, or like you can attach it to anywhere, or even you can keep it to the model. So in the example I showed before, the one which is on the screen now, so this the flag is attached to the pole. So wherever the pole goes, the pole is actually animating with the model. So wherever the pole goes, the flag is animated. So this is the basic simple model of our drones. In case you need this file or this script, this file, you can get it on my Gumroad, or you can support me as a Patreon, and you can get all my the YouTube tutorial files for free on that. So if you like this video, like it, and if you want similar kind of videos, you can just suggest the topics you want to see the videos on. Thank you.